Okay folks, welcome to my next demo. In this one, just starting off using a combination of a lot of pale colours to block in my sky. The majority's been done using Australian Grey, which is the base tone I'm using here. And over the top of that I'm using combinations of phthalo blue, phthalo green, and also some yellow green from the Art Spectrum Super Soft range. The baseboard I'm working on is a piece of mat board that I've just primed with some acrylic primer and gesso, which gives me a rough sanded surface, really good to get texture in the work, and being a solid support I can get there and do quite a bit of work with it. One of the reasons why I've chosen it is for what we'll be doing today. So not really making any major effort with the blocking, just going straight in, getting it in there and covering most of the tooth. What I will be doing is carving in some trees into that, but before we get there I'll just work on the background elements. Deepening up as we move closer to where we are. Now with the background trees, I'm just going through using a broken piece of pastel. I recommend to all of you, any little chunks and shards that you have from your pastel sticks, hold on to them, because if you can work out how to manipulate them, you get some really great effects using those tiny pieces to get trees, as you can see just here. Now the majority of the grass will be in yellows and oranges. Putting a tiny bit of Australian leaf green down, a little bit of olive as well, but most of it is going to be in the warmer tones, as this is an afternoon scene. Foreground section, I'm just going in with a pinkish orange, which works really well to give me a base tone. I am leaving a lot of the paper showing at this point. It's helping get that texture through without having to do a great deal of work for it. Just a few highlights. Now I'm coming through with a bristle brush first, and now a flat blade screwdriver. All I'm doing is carving through the underlayers of pastel to show the baseboard back up. What this allows me to do is create very, very fine detail, a lot like what you get in a scratchboard. I actually got the concept from doing some scratchboard work. And once that's in, I can just run through, as I'm doing now, with my highlight colours on the trunk to get the details in there. Now that everything's carved out, I like to put down my deeper, cooler colours first in the foliage. That deeper tone just helps pull everything together. And combinations, depending on how far away the trees are, of deep violets, deep reds, reddish browns, all work very well. Moving on to the larger tree, as you can see, carving those lines is very, very simple. Just a matter of using the blade and knocking it back. These same effects can be done on your colour fix paper. You just need to use a colour shaper to do the job, as opposed to what I've done here. The bristle brush works really well to knock back the areas and just soften allowing me to go straight in with the darker tones quite easily. Now as I move forward on these larger trees, I'm working with a great deal of variation in my colours. So while everyone thinks that trees are green, I've got a lot of oranges and reds, some deep siennas in there as well, greenish umbers, but no true green. I find it just helps get the effect of light much easier in that circumstance, and really warms things up, whereas the greens would cool it down too much. For more hints and tips, please visit the website. I also have online art classes available, where I can go into these techniques in much greater detail. Thanks for watching.